Just blocks from the Capitol building, we welcome you to Nationals Park. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the LA Dodgers and the Washington Nationals. Major League Baseball on the show is next. Paulo Espino is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Nationals. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, this guy has a four-pitch repertoire, right? And those are a lot of nice options to have. You can go hard, soft. You can go in and out. And anytime you have four pitches, if you can throw them for strikes, you have the big advantage.
And stepping in, Mookie Betts. And we are set for baseball here this evening. Now the 1-1 pitch. Temperature at first pitch. There it is, 79 degrees as we get things started tonight. Bounce towards the second baseman. Castro has it. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Next for the Dodgers, Justin Turner. High in the air down the right field line, but this will wind up being a foul ball. 3-2 pitch. Turner swings, and it's a very well hit ball to left. And that one is gone. A solo shot here to left, and the Dodgers strike first, 1-0.
Love the homer in the top of the first inning. Give your pitcher a chance to kind of regroup and gather himself with an early lead.
At the plate now, Cody Bellinger. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
Here's a bouncer foul to the left side, and the count will move ahead now to 3-2. Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. Throw on to first, two gone.
That'd be cool.
And next will be the Dodgers cleanup hitter, Will Smith. Two out, nobody on. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss at a big breaking ball, and that's how the inning comes to an end. One for the Dodgers on the solo home run. On to the bottom of the first, and LA's off to an early 1-0 lead. Clayton Kershaw is on the mound for the Dodgers in this contest. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Matt, we're getting a chance to look at one of the all-time great left-handers. Clayton Kershaw is going to go down as one of the top five lefties ever to put on a pair of cleats. He may not throw as hard as he used to, but he still has that good slider-curveball combination. He's figured out how to win with diminished velocity. Expect Clayton Kershaw to continue to find ways to get hitters out.
Into the box, Kyle Schwarber. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And he fouls this one off.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
And he tried to hold up that time. We'll get an appeal down to third, and no swing. It's ball three. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Fouled away. The next 3-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, batting he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
2-1, the count to Trey Turner. Bases are empty, one man out. Good spot for the change there, and that'll knock things up at 2-2. The pitch. Hit out towards second. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
The pitcher got the result he was looking for. Change up down in the zone gets that him to hit it on the ground, but obviously field. The result wasn't what he wanted.
Soto.
Into the box, Juan Soto. Pitch outside, the throw. Skips in and he's safe. Close play, but he's in there. Well, when a stolen base is that close, it's interesting to check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, you'll want to focus on the top speed. Really good, and it paid off there. Hot shot on the ground is short, and that's through into left, a base hit. And the tying run comes around to score from second. It's 1-1.
That's the cat and mouse of the game right there.
Batting
you find yourself count leverage, you think you're getting a heater, he throws an off-speed pitch and you're still able to execute, that fires me up right there.
Into the box now, Josh Bell. It's two balls and a strike to Josh Bell. Runners on first with one down. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
In a double play situation, you kind of expect most pitches to be down in the zone, hoping for a ground ball. So that was an interesting pitch selection to go up in the zone. I think he caught him off guard a little bit.
At the plate, Yan Gomes. High and wide, two balls and a strike. A runner on first with two away. Three and one to Yan Gomes.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
Called strike two, and now it's full 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
working for the punch out and the offering. Fouled off. Now the payoff pitch home. And it's fouled away. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Pollock has a read on it. And the inning is over. So a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Next up is Max Muncy. He'll get us started in the top of the second. And this is fouled at the plate. The 1-2 is taken but called strike three as he might have gotten a little extra off the plate that time.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
So now to the plate, Chris Taylor. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Got him.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
The shortstop, Gavin Lux.
Standing in now, Gavin Lux. Line drive to center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So instead of leading off the next inning, A.J. Pollock bats here after the two-out success.
Batting it.
Boy, just when you're looking for one of those shutdown innings, you get two quick outs, D-roll, then you give up a two-out base hit to extend the inning.
Yeah, you show me a big league ball player that's going to give away an A-B, no chance. Everybody's in there grinding every at-bat, every plate appearance. Nice job, maybe a little two-out lightning start.
Pitches high, the throw, and he is out at second. Caught stealing to end the inning. Trying to move into scoring position with two away, but not to be as we get another look. More coming up from Nationals Park in just a moment. Striding in now for the Nats, Josh Harrison. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Now Kershaw delivers a 2-2. Swing and a liner. Bellinger patrolling center makes the play, one out.
Batting seven, the second baseman, Starlin Castro.
So here's Starlin Castro. His lifetime numbers against Kershaw. He's got two hits in 32 at-bats. And on 10 occasions, he's been a strikeout victim. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
One out, nobody on. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Betts is under this one, and that's out number two.
Batting eight.
And now for Washington, Victor Robles.
Robles.
Just the second inning, but already 37 pitches to this point. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Man, that's a great take right there. Backdoor slider just missed the outside corner. This guy must have a really good eye. Most guys swing at that pitch.
Throw on to Muncy gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. Nationals gone in order. Through two, we're tied one apiece. Top of the third set to get underway, and next to bat will be the outfielder,
A.J. Pollock.
And that one yanked just foul. The 1-2. Here's a little chopper up the middle. He's got it. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single.
I know that has to be frustrating from a pitcher's standpoint, but nice execution, nice hustle. Bottom line, nice hustle. Pitcher still one good pitch away from getting a double play.
You know, D-Row, one of the things you want to do is make quality pitches as a pitcher, and there's not much you can do right there. You make a pretty good pitch, and the next thing you know, you have a leadoff single on an infield ground ball.
At the plate now, Clayton Kershaw tries to get the bunt down here, but this is foul, and we'll see if he tries it again. The 1-2. And with two strikes, he's able to get this one down. One there. Well, he'll put this in his pocket and be content with just the one out. One out, runner at first, and that'll bring up Mookie Betts. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Runner on first here with one gone and a 1-1 tie. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
Into the box, Justin Turner got him swinging, and that's the third out. Dodgers leave one. Home half of the third coming up, tied at one. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Paulo Espino.
Nope.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. But sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Strike two taken, a fastball that clips the inside black. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2. Kyle Schwarber is on deck. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. He's right there. And there's one away.
The bat.
So one out, nobody aboard. And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Kyle Schwarber. Kershaw now on 1-1. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Bases are empty, one man out. And he fouls this one off. Lays off, 2-2 now.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. But speedy Trey Turner digs in now. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. Called strike two.
Hey, with two outs in the number two hole, you're just trying to get on. You got the big boys coming up behind you.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fat.
We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Washington. Through three complete, all tied one apiece. And back in our nation's capital, before we get too much further on the field, let's check in with Heidi.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. All set for the start of the fourth. And digging in is the outfielder, Cody Bellinger. Here's the 1-1 pitch. And a half swing here, but this is in there for a called strike two. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Full count to Bellinger, three balls, two strikes.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Bellinger connects as this is deep to right. And that's a home run into the top tank. It's a solo homer for Cody Bellinger, and the Dodgers move out in front. It's 2-1.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup, so a home run, a solo home run right here, it's not the end of the world.
To the plate now, Will Smith. Now a shot toward the gap in left center. He's around first, heading for two. And they'll keep it going here as he's in with a double. Off the bat, it was pretty clear right away that that hit was going to get him at least two bases.
Yeah, Matt, some people like to crow about homers and towering drives, but you have to like hits like this. A no-doubt double the second it left his bat. Like you said, the only question was whether the outfielders were going to be able to keep him at second, which they did.
In now, Max Muncy. Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Left fielder giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. Next up for Los Angeles, Chris Taylor struck out in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Schwarber is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone, and up next will be Gavin Lux. Two runs, five hits, no errors for the Dodgers thus far. Throw on to Bell at first, and the side is retired. But the Dodgers add on courtesy of this solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up, 2-1 Los Angeles. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in the outfielder, Juan Soto. The 3-1. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
Just flat out froze him there. Nothing too deceptive about that four-seam fastball. So
19,
I think he wasn't expecting it
Josh
at all.
Bell.
Stepping in now, Josh Bell. 1-1 pitch and a nice call for the change. It's 1-2.
Man, this has been a game filled of a lot of swings and misses. Not very many confident swings, and this team up there, they'd swing at a butterfly right now if it flew in front of the plate. Lots of swings, lots of misses, a lot of ugly at-bats for this team right now.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
He's really on a roll
now
right now on the mound.
Catcher.
Back-to-back strikeouts to wrap up the last inning.
Go.
And now he started this frame with the same story. Four straight strikeouts in all.
At the plate, Yan Gomes. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Pollock has a read on it. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. Nationals gone in order. They're down 2-1. And now, A.J. Pollock. He'll start off the fifth in this one. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Gotta find a way to keep his hands back.
Another 1-2 delivery.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Gomes gathers it, and he makes the throw to first. Pollock is retired, and there's one away. So bases are empty with one gone, and up next will be the pitcher, Clayton Kershaw. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. And, oh, he definitely broke the plane there as he went after the pitch inside, and it's strike two. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away.
That was a nasty pitcher's pitch right there. Most guys strike out on that one. He was able to scramble out a little bit and give him another chance. And hopefully this pitcher misses over the heart of the plate.
In time to first, and there are two away. So it's back to the top of the order now. And up next, one of the terrific talents in the game, Mookie Betts. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Not quite out of here. It's off the out-of-town scoreboard. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
This right here is the difference between an average hitter and a very good hitter. The average hitter probably doesn't do anything with that pitch, but this guy goes down and gets it, muscling it to the outfield for an extra base hit.
So now to the plate, Justin Turner. Slapped hard the opposite way. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And the runner from second is in to score. It's now 3-1.
What a frustrating inning from a pitcher standpoint, D-Roy. You get the first two out of the inning, the next guy doubles, and then you give up a two-out base hit to drive in a run.
Yeah, and you want to talk about on the complete flip side, firing up an offense. You see your two boys go down, two quick outs. You mix in a gapper right there. Double finds himself on second base, and he's able to come through. Next guy's able to come through with a big two-out knock.
Helping him out here as he swings and misses to fall behind a ball and two strikes. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. I tried to backdoor him there, but it's a full count now, 3-2.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. It's a run on two hits here for L.A. So now to the plate, Josh Harrison, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth.
This is where the pressure starts to build a little bit on an offense. It's not late enough. I mean, you don't have to start panicking right now, but this is where you're looking for someone to light a spark to get back in this game.
Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Popped up. Lux is under it, one away.
The batter, number 13.
Here's Starlin Castro.
Second base
flew out in his only at bat so far.
Castro.
One out, nobody on. Tries to dump this one out to left. That's his first base hit, making one for two now.
Boy, this is just a case of another really good hitter finding a way, even though that was a soft liner, finding a way to get hits.
Yeah, he usually hits rockets and catches the barrel, but even his soft liners fall. Dan, he has a knack for keeping his bat in his zone and giving himself a chance much longer than the average ball player.
Standing in now, Victor Robles. A double play ball to second. Four, six, three. But it's not in time, and the inning will continue. Ryan Zimmerman will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 11, Ryan Zimmerman.
One run on three hits, and no errors so far for the Nationals. Fouled off. Kershaw comes set. We'll try to put him away here on 2-2. Swing and a line drive. In there, a base hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
Boy, it's so frustrating now as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
Into the box, Kyle Schwarber, and it's fouled away. 3-1 our score as we play inning number 5. And And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Nats leave a pair. They still trail it here 3-1. Austin Voth takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 50, Austin Voth.
Top half of the sixth about to get started, and next to hit is the catcher, Will Smith. The 1-1. Waves and misses for strike number two.
You know, it's funny right there. You look at that pitch, and it's almost a hybrid in between a big-time old-school curveball and a nasty slider that goes off the fastball. That's kind of right in the middle right there, kind of working off the clock, that 3-8, if you can picture that in your head. Tough pitch to lay off of.
He stays alive, still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
So a runner at first now with nobody out, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Fastball laid off well below the knees. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Two pitches fouled away. We're in the sixth inning here in a 3-1 ball game. And he fouls this one off. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
In now, Chris Taylor. And he lays off the pitch down and away. Ball two. The 2-1 is strike two swinging.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
The 2-2. Hit hard on the ground to second. There's one. Relay to Bell. The double play. And that's how the inning ends. Dodgers go down quietly as the lead remains 3-1. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Trey Turner. Towards second. And that's the first out. Here now is Juan Soto, a hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. There's a breaking ball, but it's laid off and doesn't find the zone.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
All even now, 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at-bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Good battle. Count remains full. Fouled away. The next 3-2. Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
Yeah, and if you can make it all the way to the sixth inning before you give up a walk, you're doing something right. He's been very efficient so far, so we'll see if he can get back on track here.
Josh Bell the next to hit. He went down on strikes last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
And this will be fouled away. Did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike three.
No hitter is now ever going to feel good about taking the hat trick with three strikeouts in a game, but I will say he's not the first guy to have a terrible game against my man on the mound. And you know what? He won't be the last. We all know he's one of the best in the business for a reason.
Into the box now, Yan Gomes hit weakly on the ground to short. Scooped up, a flip will go to Taylor at second for the force, and the inning is over. Nationals leave one. Score holds, it's 3-1. Now to the plate, here is Gavin Lux. He bounced out last time up. The 1-1 is looked at for ball number two. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Got him swinging on the split fingered pitch, and that's out number one.
Now batting.
Next, here is A.J. Pollock. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. The 2-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two. Still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. So here's the Dodgers pitcher, Clayton Kershaw. No hits to this point. Dodgers pitcher trying to deal with a 1-2 count at the plate.
Hey, this guy obviously feels he can move traffic right here. He's taking two big swings. He's trying to help himself.
And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Dodgers down in order, and it's still 3-1. Last half of the seventh here, and set to go is the third baseman, Josh Harrison. And he rings up another one, make it 9 strikeouts for him in the game.
It looked like this at-bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
To the plate now, Starlin Castro. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
Now the 2-1. High in the air out to center field. Bellinger's under it. Two gone.
Now back.
Victor Robles digging in now. Victor. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. Robles. On the ground to the right side. Taylor showing off his range. Throw on to Muncy gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. Dodgers out in front, 3-1. Ready to begin the 8th, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Mookie Betts. The 1-1. Fouled off. The 1-2.
I love the fact that the hitter was able to foul that pitch away. I always thought with two strikes, you give the pitcher that inside part of the plate and you do your best to cover away.
And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Justin Turner will stride in one more time as we flash you back to earlier. This was a big blow right here as he leaves the yard with plenty to spare. Eighth inning of this low scoring affair. 3-1 our score. Hit the other way out toward right field. Soto will wait on it, and there's the second out of the inning. Two away for the Dodgers here in the 8th. And that brings up the former National League MVP, Cody Bellinger. Two out, nobody on. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground to the left side.
Up next for the Dodgers, the catcher, Will Smith.
At the plate now, Will Smith. Three. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. One left for L.A. as the lead remains 3-1. Blake Treinen is on the pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th.
For the Dodgers, number 49, Blake Treinen.
Jordy Mercer will try and get his club back into it here as he'll pinch hit to lead off the home half of the 8th. Offers it that one a little late, and it's 2-2 now.
This offense has been underachieving all day, putting way too much pressure on their own pitching staff. Someone has to have a quality AB and get this line going.
The 2-2 pitch is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Final line there for the Dodgers starting pitcher. He was on point from the get-go this evening.
The left fielder,
Matty V, really a solid performance. Seven strong innings pitched, in line for the win. Needs some help for the bullpen to close this one out.
Standing in now, Kyle Schwarber. Three balls and a strike to the Nationals left fielder.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. One out, nobody on. Drill down the line. And this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball. And now it'll kick around in the corner. And he'll reach second now with one away.
That's what you call a clutch piece of hitting. Down two runs, he puts himself in scoring position and brings the tying run to the plate. We'll see what they do with the base open here. This one's getting interesting.
At the plate, Trey Turner. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Three and one to the National shortstop.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
The 3-1 pitch. Sharp ground ball toward the hole. And that's through into left, a base hit. Now a long throw home. Play at the plate, and he's out. A great throw.
He's trying his hardest to help his guys get back in the game, but this time he had no shot. Applaud the hustle, but the decision was a costly one.
In now, Juan Soto. Broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. One left for Washington, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. Number 60 enters from the bullpen to do the pitching.
Number 60.
Now at the plate, here is Max Muncy, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field. And this one is gone, a home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. And the Dodgers move out in front now, 4-1.
They still have the bottom of the ninth to try and stage a comeback. But one thing that's not coming back is this blast to extend the lead to 3. Nice knowing you've got some room for error, especially on the road.
So now to the plate, Chris Taylor. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike 2. Action now in the Washington bullpen as a right-hander begins to get loose. Now the 3-2 pitch. Here's a pop-up now. There to play it is Castro, and he's got it for the first out.
The batter, number 9.
Next to stand in is Gavin Lux, struck out in his last trip to the plate. High and wide, two balls and a strike. set to deliver on 2-1.
Three balls, one strike.
Bases are empty, one man out. Skied into straightaway right. Soto is back in. Plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone.
The left fielder.
So the next to bat will be
A.J. Pollock.
He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Bell in foul ground. And that will end the inning. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. Last chance coming up here for the Nationals. It's now 4-1 LA. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Kenley Jansen enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth. Digging in, the switch hitter, Josh Bell. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable. Even when you're at home to score 3 runs off a closer like this guy, they've got the work cut out for him.
Now the 1-1 pitch. And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. 4 strikeouts.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have 2 more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
Now the 1-1 pitch. And it's fouled away. 1 out, nobody on. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Now here's the pitch. And he fouls this one off. Fouled away. Fouled off. Ready with another 2-2. And he finally puts him away here as he strikes him out after an 11-pitch at bat.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, 2 strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Last strike now for the Nats. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Lifted in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder is on the move. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Well, folks, that's what Kenley Jansen does. When he enters the game, the hopes of the other team, they usually just leave. Slams the door again right here.
A 4-1 finish in this evening's game. Los Angeles took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Clayton Kershaw is the winning pitcher of record. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers, 4 runs on 9 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base.